going to be playing a couple of my own songs. I'm not going to be singing. I'm just on the guitar. I'm just going to tune it up. Second song. I don't really have much of an introduction to it. Can you guys hear it?
Thank you. that's it.
Thank you very much.
Next we have Amar Ali Amir performing.
हाँ मैं हसाम लीड गिटारिस्ट है और माइक का वॉल्यूम थोड़ा कम है. हेलो 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 ठीक है सही है. अच्छा जी मेहदी हसन खान साहब की एक गज़ल है अब के हम बिछड़े वो शुरू करते हैं उसमें देख लेते हैं आगे कुछ भी होगी. बहुत ज्यादा स्लो गाना था ये. Thank you.
इश्क की आग कुछ खेल नहीं, इश्क की आग पानी न समझिए आग है, लगी भूल जानी पड़े दिल लगी भूल जानी पड़े, मोहब्बत की राहों में आकर तो देखो तड़पने पे मेरे ना फिर तुम सोगे, इश्क की आग देख के मुझे क्यों तुम देखते नहीं, आराज फिर हाँ सही तो से तुम्हें प्यार से प्यार होने लगेगा, तुम्हें प्यार से प्यार होने लगेगा, कभी दिल किसी से लगा
चाहिए। मैं एक लास्ट मैशअप कर रहा हूँ उसके बाद बस खत्म।
हसी रात हो ना
Chairman. Next up we have Abdul Sheikh. He's very excited to perform.
I'm trying to figure out what to play.
Thank you.
Thank you. Next up, I'll be singing Mora Sanya by Kamaj Fusion / Shafqat Amanat Ali / me, basically. Last one. This one's called Balma by Rahat and Ali Asmat. And I could use Ahmed on this one if he doesn't mind. Rahat wale parts aap karenge. Aapke liye.
Tore na na re, tore. नारे तोरे नैना रे नारे काटे नाही बाल मां तोरे
नैना नैना ले गए चना रे ना काटे नाही
बाल तोरे नैना नैना रे
गे चना रे ना काटे नाही
नी 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 सपने रे रे नी सा सा बनी रे रे नी सा पानी रे मा पानी मा पानी मा पानी
जान मा
बाल मा बाल मा
ना
थैंक यू
Thank you very much. Next up, we have Daniel and Sufyan. Yeah, Daniel, Sufyan, ek hi, acha do. Okay.
So hey guys, this is Randanil Huber with Sufyan Khan, and we both are beatboxers, and I do something rap. So I hope you will enjoy. Yeah. मैं लड़ू हाथ से मैं मारू सबको बात से मौके वालों पंखों पर रहो तुम औकात में अल्फाज मेरे थे तेरे मुंह पर चमाटे इस गेम का हूँ फाइटर स्ट्राइकर पड़ेंगे लाते मुके घुसे झंडे पड़े को गुफू कराटे हाथ नहीं आऊंगा मैं थक जाओगे तुम अपने गाने बनाते बनाते इधर पब्लिक को सुनाते सुनाते तुम्हारे जैसे रोज यहाँ आते और जाते जाली रैपरों पढ़ने वाला अब छापा है भागो सारे घरों को इधर तुम्हारे पापा है So, now I'm thinking something beatbox, I hope you will enjoy. Thank you.
Boom.
you very much, Daniel and Sufyan. Next up we have Noreen.
Includes travel blogs as well, and I maintain a Facebook by the same name. So I'm going to give one prose and one poem to the audience today. So here goes. First, I'm going to do a prose by the name of Our Rising Rapids. I had never been a roller coaster kind of person. I hope it's not echoing. Is it okay? Or is it echoing? Okay. I had never been a roller coaster kind of person. Always thought rides taking me through dark tunnels, bottomless pits, and through unexpected sprays of icy cold water would scare the hell out of me. Till 2 years ago, I could always slip out of these futile experiences, tricking my family one way or the other. Then my girls grew up to become more of my pals than my daughters. They would tease me on how I resembled a scared mouse scurrying about in adventure parks trying to hide. They convinced me to experience at least one ride before I gave my final verdict on them. I soon found myself being pushed like sausage meat in its tight casing and then being knotted on either ends. Girls chose a much milder ride by the name of Rising Rapids for all of us to enjoy together. Both of them clutched my hands from either side, reassuring me that it wouldn't be my last day on the planet. I took my leap of faith and sat in a little red seat. Automatic locks latched onto us firmly. I'm sure from far away we look like colored tufts of hair bobbing up and down in a huge caterpillar. Soon a recorded voice bellowed in everyone's ears. 3, 2, 1. After that sound, time just went zoop, and so did we all with it. Charged humans of all sizes and shapes were screaming insanely. I discovered I wasn't any different. A new realization dawned upon me. How liberating it was to scream like a maniac. I was surrounded by equally electrified humans who indulged in the same act as we all enjoyed this temporary fit of madness. What a unique experience, and what an expression of an excited scream is, and what an utter delight the adrenaline rush was. Unbelievable. Before we knew it, the ride had ended with a grand finale. We had landed in a pool of water, gushing and spraying us from all directions. Everyone was chucked out of the dreamlike experience. I found myself giggling like a girl of 10 who had just been gifted with a dollhouse. A sparkle of excitement surrounded my entire being, as if by some magic wand, which had just sprinkled an emotion of utter delight over me. Girls were utterly proud of their achievement when they witnessed a sprightly me for the rest of the day. The experience made me realize that we grown-ups are wise, experienced, motivated, but at the same time can be very boring. We forget to experience life as a whole and are only focused on goals. So let's not be grown-ups all the time. If nothing else, let's begin to realize and relish simple everyday pleasures. Punctuate endless sentences of monotonous life with semicolons of foolishness, commas of silliness, and full stops of laughter, the kind that hurts our flanks and tear up our eyes. After that blessed trip, I have entertained myself on endless accounts by swinging on the very basic of swings in parks. After sunsets, of course, as I don't want to be labeled as a mad freak, I have come to consciously appreciate a broad grin on our faces every time we taste ultimate tangy tamarind chutney. We squeeze our eyes shut and smile gleefully with the first killer sour burst in our mouth. Then we comment on the very obvious, "Oh, that's so sour." bursting out randomly into a song gets everyone in splits, especially if one sounds like a croaking frog in the monsoon season rather than a grown-up lady. Making my car stop all of a sudden to steal an apple from someone's farm has been highly amusing. It got even more exciting when I had to run to my car for the sake of a shred of decency that remained when the farmer spotted me. Then there are comparatively saner pleasures to choose from, in case you aren't as weird as grown-ups as I am. I mean, simple childlike indulgences. Bury your nose deep into a bunch of fragrant flowers and shut your eyes. Inhale deeply. Let only one sense come to life, while others can go on a mini vacation. Trust me, it's very gratifying. If by chance you're a rain kind of person, then the smell of fresh air after a slight drizzle does the same trick. If you want, you can always let the sense of touch participate too by being without an umbrella. I have a bizarre habit of conversing with my ferns, vines, and plants when I bathe and feed them with a water hose. Love ignites within me, and I'm sure they rejoice too. After all, who doesn't enjoy getting pampered? For my simple everyday pleasures, the adorable Winnie the Pooh still helps. But one act makes me mushier than a bowl of soft, buttery peas. That, ladies and gentlemen, is a heartfelt, tight hug around my most precious gems. Those beautiful blocks of my Lego being. I mean, my two lovely daughters. What are your rising rapids? Do choose them, relish them, and live them. That, to me, is true bon vivant. Thank you. Just a poem, which is on a totally different tangent of emotion, to get you a feel of the serious side of my writing. The poem is called Loneliness or Solitude. And then one day, loneliness transforms itself into solitude. Blissful solitude. When you are all you have and that's all you need, then you crave no translations, none and from no one. Just as the sound of rain needs no translation. Soulful music needs no translation. The look in someone's eyes needs none either. A kiss, a tight embrace, a tearful eye, a quivering lip need no translation. But I often wonder, does silence need translation? Silence of an empty house needs none, but silence of a living being? Can it have 1,000 reiterations? Or does it have 1,000 answers? Maybe 1,000 questions? But love needs infinite translations. It needs repetitive translations. Sometimes it craves sweet words. Sometimes a meaningful glance, sometimes just a bare hug. A hurried peck on the forehead, a slow kiss on the cheek, a tight hand's clutch. But what it needs the most is perception and recognition. In simple everyday questions, how was your day? Did you sleep well? What did the doctor say? Did you eat well? Give wings to those you love. Trust and they will stay. Bind them and they'll run away. Solitude, your blissful solitude, will transform into loneliness. You'll crave translations, but only silence will stay.
Hello. So next up we have Sneaky Zeeky. Please put your hands together for me.
Okay, this looks like an expensive mic for someone dressed like me in Sadar ki chappal or whatever. I like how we have really good looking businessmen here, right here. You know, they're like, really, like, he's staring me down. He's just like, One bad joke, we have kids. Every time I'm about to curse, I'm gonna do a reaction. You know, like a weird reaction, like when you look at your grades, you're just like, oh no! Crap! Oh, I said the C word. What's your name, buddy? It doesn't matter what your name is, because you're gonna grow up to be a good person one day and you're gonna rock it. Am I right? He's just gonna laugh it off. Like, kids, you know, because you will like, I kind of don't like kids, you know? I kind of don't, because, like, I mean, they're adorable. Yeah, you're adorable. So is she. Like, you guys are cool. Like, I don't mind if you guys are the next Obama or whatever. It's fine, you know? Like, it's bomb children and be like, oh, we save children. No, you don't. You're liars. All right. I'm from Saudi Arabia. But don't worry, I'm not gonna blow anyone up. Or I'm not gonna be like, hey, laugh at my jokes, I'll blow you up. And you guys will, I'm pretty sure he will respond like, yeah, but do it outside. You know, I got a bank job, you know, I got a family, and I'm like, whatever. So, yeah, the reason I don't like kids is because they cry. I mean, like, yes, you can cry when you're depressed, yeah, life. What are you crying about, man? Just because you couldn't have extra candy? Oh, come on! He's my favorite audience right now. Like, guys, you just, come on. Like, come on, man. Guys, like, come on, man. Do something. I mean, like, comedians who ask for responses. Sadar kaam, it's fine. And this is from Zara Marki, just by the way. Embracing it, you know? I mean, anyways, I was saying children. The reason I don't like it when they cry is because they don't cry normally, you know? Like, eh, or, oh. Unka ek tarika hai. Like, you know, they trigger. There are three types. Number one, the one that gives you a warning with a face. Example, you know, we have to kill you, you have to. And just like, I love this kid, man. Let him laugh. It's fine. I love him. I mean, you guys learned something, man. Talk about encouragement. You're weird, man. The kids are weird, but like, I like how I'm just insulting him and he's laughing at it. He's like, ah, le meri mar. Beat me, come on. That's how we, most good people are. As I was saying, so this one time I went on a date, and you know where this is going, you know, it doesn't end well, because when a date doesn't go well, that guy becomes a stand-up comedian, you know where this is going. So, obviously, this was my first date. I was like, you know, I need some advice, you know, like, how do I treat her? Like, obviously, movies mein dekha hai, banda aata hai, gaadi mein, limousine wagaira mein, you know, or like, pick up karta wagaira. Main toh hai, chinchi, but like, hi! And with a broken bow tie wagaira. So, they said, you know what, the best advice I can give you, brother? I'm like, yeah. He's like, treat her like your mother, with respect. I'm like, sure. Baithe, okay, you know, like, I was like, after you. Baithe, so I was like, and the guy just pops up again, he's just like, remember, treat her like you treat your mother. Mama, 50 rupees hai? And she's just like, Jesus, mom's on me. I'm the hardest girl. I give you a chance. I'm like, oh shit, teacher. Brother, what did you do? I was joking. You took it seriously. Hey, you Arab fuck. I was like, wow. Okay, kids. Oh, I didn't react. Censor board. I like how he's just staring at me right now again. He's just like, what does this kid do for a living? Like, is this it? Dude, go study. Don't be a dropout. You're not Mark Zuckerberg. I mean, if you do become the Mark Zuckerberg, the only phase you live in his life was the one where he got caught and he was drinking water. Can I have a glass of water? Can anyone give me a glass of water? Anyone? Excuse me. Handsome guy with the glasses. Can I have a glass of water, if you don't mind? Lambi kar rahe hain jaise Pakistani politicians karte na, lambi kar rahe hain. Let's just wait. It's okay. You guys watch Big Boss anyway. What are you crying about? Can I have a glass of water, please? Anyone? That'll take a time, I'll just wait for that. Mark Zuckerberg at that 5 minutes. Anyway, as I was saying, I'm also an impersonist, and I impersonate anything I find interesting. Like, have you guys seen The Dictator? Anyone? Raise your hands, because, like, you know, you guys are just like, yeah, I've seen it. Y'all get it. You know, typical, they see, you know, like, full, but oh, yeah, we'll just stick to this. Basically, yeah, carpet ganda ho gaya, fir mind to nahi karenge, thoda sa gir gaya. He's just like, yeah, hamara property diye karde ganda, yaar chill. Basically, this is my the Mark Zuckerberg part of life. Beta, kya karte ho? Beta, shaadi kab kar rahe ho? Laugh na, kyunki tumhi to kar raha hu. Bas. Bada aaya, free ho raha tha. अजीब मतलब एक तो हंसता पर हंसता नहीं है मेक अप योर माइंड मैन डोंट लाइक माय गर्लफ्रेंड हु जस्ट डंप्स मी एंड देन कम्स बैक एंड देन डंप्स मी एंड कम्स बैक And that's okay. That's what happens when she's around with defense ke londe, jo ki jawan hoti hai, you know, leather jacket pehne ghum rahe hain, which is too tight for them. I know those. I think those girls are offended. They're like, "Achha, mere boyfriend ke baare mein? Wo leather jacket pehnta hai? Uski jawan hoti hai? Kya bol raha? Aaja sadar ka londa. Aise hi marungi na." This is a joke. You know, Akbar Chaudhary. You guys know Akbar Chaudhary, right? Raise your hand so I can, you know kya bolna. One. Wow. That's my man right there. Anyone else? No, no, so let's just leave that. So yeah, Dictator. How many guys have you seen The Dictator? Raise your hands. I like this guy. He may be too old for me, but yeah, you cool, bro. So Dictator.
Well, I love to be an American. America number one. My father from USA. My great grandfather fought in the Civil War Jihad. I love to be an American. I am America's number. I'm also Pakistan's number one douche. Yeah.
Laugh. Laugh. Laugh, bro. Yeah. Give me five. Too slow. Go back to kindergarten, y'all. And it's a really, by the way, it's a really weird phase in my life these days. You know, I'm like struggling with my career and whatever, making films and whatever, self-promoting and stuff. And at the same time, I'm like battling this thought, you know, like this is life, this is death, in the middle, exams. Okay, that's my bridge. Oh, what's up? Exam is the DI needs in the email, Hazrat. You guys should be laughing. I'm sure you guys gave exams. I mean, like, beta exam kya aata hai? Hey, that's the best response. Yeah, you just laugh at it. You know, that's how you know you're a good audience. You laugh at it. You laugh at it. And this is my personal thing I might want to share. You know, okay, how many of you hate medicines? Do you just hate the taste, the flavor? Wow, she's staring at me like, I love medicine. What do you kya kar lega? Benadryl de. I was like, I get it, you love medicines, bro. Are you studying doctor or artist? I think she cursed me. So kuch aur hai, she's like, I was like, and she's wearing glasses, so obviously she's smarter than me. Anyone who wears glasses is just better than me in any way, even though he doesn't know shit, but I'm pretty sure she does. Because obviously, if I say something, I'll kill him. I'll kill him. I'm like, what do you want to go? I'm like, take it easy, man. Take it easy. So as I was saying, this is probably something only he will laugh at. Beta, hasa hasa hasa. Okay. You know your mark. I love this kid, man. Every time I take a medicine or whatever, this is like, no matter how normal it is, no matter how sick I am to react even, this is my, not just my initial, but my general reaction. You know, like, okay, there's a pill, and pill, and like, that wasn't so bad. It tastes like shit. I can be Michael Jackson. Let me moonwalk. It's okay. I'm just doing what Humayun Sayyid does. You know, it's disappoint people. Oh, I went there. Is anyone a Humayun Sayyid fan here? Thank God. You know how Pakistani people are. Kuch bolo, they're those. You say something about my friend? Bros! You say something about my family? Bros! Koi nahi kehta ki yaar agli baar nahi karna, I just don't like you. That's the solution to everything. I love this kid, man. Give him a round of applause. Come on, he's the best audience member here. And my time is almost up. I hope you enjoyed me being a total weirdo. This is what I do in my room all the time, just letting you know. Alright, maybe that's why my relationships failed. Probably because she was hanging out with defense ke jawline wale londe. You know, like, jawline se apni abrishan karte. Stuff. And these two, thank you for just staring me in the eye and giving me nightmares. I cannot sleep tonight. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Hello. Yeah. Thank you so much, Sneaky Zeke. Up next, we have the last performance for the evening by Zain Hashmi. Can we please have you on the stage?
One is La Vie en Rose and the other is Creep by Radiohead. They're both covers that, oh. All right, great. That I'm doing on the ukulele. All right.
Hold me close and hold me fast, the magic spells you cast. This is Lavian Rose. When you kiss me, heaven sighs, and though I close my eyes, this is Lavian Rose. And when you press me to your heart, I'm in a world apart, a world where roses bloom. And when you speak, angels sing from above. Everyday words seem to turn into love songs. Bring your heart and soul to me, and life will always be lovely and rose.
Thank you. All right, could you guys hear the ukulele for that? Yeah, all right, great. So for this next song, ukulele isn't so great, but hopefully I'll make up for that.
When you were here before, couldn't look you in the eyes. You're dressed like an angel. Your skin makes me cry. And you float like a feather in a beautiful world. You're so very special. Yeah, I wish I was special, but I'm a creep. I'm a weirdo. What the hell am I doing here? I don't belong here. I don't care if it hurts. I want to have control. I want the perfect body. I want the perfect soul. And I want you to notice when I'm not around. You're so very special. Yeah, I wish I was special, but I'm a creep. I'm a weirdo. What the hell am I doing here? I don't belong here. Oh, oh, she's wrong. Oh, she's running out again. I said she's running out again. Whatever makes you happy, whatever you want. You're so very special. Yeah, I wish I was special, but I'm a creep. I said it, I'm a weirdo. Oh, oh, oh. What the hell am I doing here? I don't belong here.